Okay, so today I'm going to show you guys how to do intro to fashion sketching. So I always start with a croquis. It's totally normal in the fashion industry to start with a croquis. And you'll notice your croquis kind of develops over time. This is something I think I've kind of, you know, developed over the lifeline of my career. But you basically want to put it underneath some paper so you can kind of get the basic outline. And then you just want to start using your pencil to kind of start drawing. Now I'm going to draw one of the ways to wear the multi-chic wrap. That's from my new line. And I kind of want to show how it can be worn as a wrap top. So we're going to draw the wrap top right now. And it's good to always have the wrap or whatever you're drawing in front of you. Maybe on a mannequin or as a photograph or something to kind of follow along. So that you can really see like the details and the folds of what's happening. So I'm just gonna sketch this like this. And you're just using pencil, so you can erase, you can do, you know, if you make mistakes or you don't like it, you can always go back later, kind of change it around. But you wanna make sure to draw all the folds and the creases and everything that's kind of going on. Once you have the top, I like to go back and just do the body a little bit. I'm only really going to do a half body. You'll notice I don't always draw the head. I particularly don't like to draw heads. I don't know why, I just don't. Not very good at it, I think. So I leave my girls headless, and that's totally fine. Half the time in the industry, you're sketching so fast that you don't really have time to be very detail-oriented with heads and hands and feet. So if you're not good at drawing those types of things, don't worry about it. It's more about the garment, especially if you're working with an overseas factory and you need to tell them how to make something. They're not going to care what your head or your hands look like on your sketch. They only want to see what the garment looks like. And there you go. There's your pencil sketch. Okay, so now that you have your pencil sketch, you're going to want to take your fat black marker and go over just the outline of the garment itself. You want a nice thick outline on the actual garment because you kind of want it to stand out from the rest of your sketch. And you can fill in some of the fold lines and things like that too. Next, you can take your thinner fine point marker. These are the Pigma Micron 03 and 08. I like to use these ones because they don't seem to dry up as fast. And you can use that to go over the body. That way your body doesn't stand out so much, but you still have nice clean lines. Some of the fold lines as well with the thinner marker. Next, you're going to want to take your eraser and erase all the pencil lines and make sure that your marker is dry because you don't want to be smudging the marker all over the place. I'm going to erase all my pencil lines just like this. Next, I like to do the flesh color. I like to use Blondewood. It's a pretty good, decent tone. This is the Prismacolor. And I just use the fat end and kind of just start on the outside of the body and kind of work my way in so that the inner's a little bit lighter. And you can create like nice shadows with this marker. It's actually really, really good marker. Thank you. I like to do is take a felt tip marker. I really like these ones. These are the Staedtler Mars Graphic 3000 Duo. They have a really good felt tip. Kind of acts almost like a paintbrush. And I like to go in and kind of just add some darker spots in the folds. You don't want to go too crazy, but you want to add a little bit, you know, dimension to your sketch. And then while it's still wet, you want to take, that was a dark gray color, you want to take a lighter gray. This is Cool Grey 20% Prismacolor. And I use the fat end and I kind of just go in and make it look a little bit more blended in. And even though I'm not coloring the sketch in, I just want it to be a black and white sketch. I kind of want it to look like it's not just white. Then I'm just gonna color in her pants just so it looks like she's not naked. And you can leave a little bit of space for white right where the crotch would be. That way, it's kind of like a highlight. You can leave it like that, or you can kind of fill it in. You can also take your dark gray felt tip so that it's just not all black, but that you still have kind of some dimension going on there. Kind of like that. Layering markers is a really good trick so that it blends in really well. There you go, you have a wonderful detailed colored in sketch. Now I've already sketched all the other ones, so I'm just going to continue coloring them in the same way I did that one. Now you have your finished, beautiful, colored in sketches. I'm Christine D'Angelo, your fashion angel warrior, showing you how to do fashion sketching 101. Stay tuned for next time.